One week in, 20 weeks out, this is part one of my newest bikini competition vlog series. What's going on, strong friends? Welcome to part one of my six-part bikini competition vlog series of my first 2020 upcoming bikini competition. So this is going to be six parts. This is the intro part of it. I'm gonna do one video every month, so four of them, and then there's gonna be a recap at the end. So this is just kind of the introduction, what I wanna tell you, what I'm doing, what the plan is with my coaches and I, and what you can expect, or hopefully what I can expect over the next 4 months. So I am back with Atlas Bodybuilding because they were a phenomenal team. I absolutely loved Humberto's coaching with his nutrition and training guidance. I did talk about that in my last bikini competition vlog series, so go back and check that out. I am with Kat again for posing. Again, she is with Atlas as well, so I am with the dream team. The cool thing is they're actually both based out of Winnipeg as well, so I get to see them when I do the show in May. So very excited. I think that's pretty much the reason why I wanted to do that competition. Back with the same team again, so it's no new drill for me. I know what to expect, I know what's going on, I know basically what our plan is. Nutrition, gonna get into that first. Currently, I am working on increasing my calories. This is not going to be 21 weeks of dieting down, because if you have seen my physique or know what I look like, I honestly don't have much weight at all to lose. It's just working on fine-tuning. I have some areas on my body that I really need to build up, so really try to overload some muscle development over the next 21 weeks. That means I need to be in a bit of a caloric surplus in order to promote healthy muscle growth. So after that last competition that I did, August 2019, I did cut back on a lot of calories. More or less, I'm not gonna get into it, but there was a lot of lifestyle changes. So we have recently pushed my calories back up. I am just over 2,200 calories, and that is on all days, all training and rest days. The reason for that is because we do want to push some more calories into my body, promote more muscle growth, so we're not doing carb cycling at the moment. Right now, it's 2,200 calories, which for me, it's easy because it's just literally eating the same thing every day, and I don't have to think about if it's training or a non-training day. And currently, my training, a little bit different from the last time, but still similar. So it's 3 days on, 1 day off, repeat twice. So I have six different workouts that I complete, and then I repeat the cycle. Basically, it is back and forth between glutes and shoulders with some accessories in there as well. So it's like glutes, shoulders, glutes, rest, shoulders, glutes, shoulders, with like the upper body and the back and the pull and the quads and all that. But for the most part, the two areas that I really need to work on are my glutes and my shoulders for this competition. So We're working on them here. I am still incorporating a little bit of SPD work, squat, bench press, and deadlift, just because I really liked it. I asked Humberto if we could keep it in, and he's letting me, which is great, so I can still keep that powerlifting element, because to be honest, I'm still a powerlifting girl at heart, and maybe I'm just being naive and admitting that now, but I believe I'm still a powerlifting girl, and I still really like those heavy lifts, and I still wanted to keep them in, so we're keeping them in. I am learning new bikini posing, and the reason for that is the last federation I competed in and this federation, they are different, which means they're different standards. I'm not sure if I'm going to be attaching any posing videos along with these updates, maybe as they go, but as I'm recording this right now, I'm not sure if I'm going to be doing that. I don't want to get too fixed or showing people things that might not be realistic, might not be relevant, and honestly, I don't want to be posting my posing videos and getting feedback from people when I'm not asking for feedback. That's, to be completely honest, I'm sure you can respect that. I want feedback right now from one person, and that is my posing coach. And then on competition day, I want feedback from the judges, and that's it. I don't want feedback from the people on the interwebs, you know? I did ask you guys what kind of questions you wanted me to answer, what you wanted me to share, and a lot of them were talking about the struggles and my mindset. And of course, I do want to share that in the episodes that I do after this one, talking about, okay, so maybe I'm going through this challenge, kind of how I go through it or what my mindset is. Now, I do check in with my coaches every week. I am doing posing with Kat. So far, it's going to be about once every 10 days, give or take, depending on how much work I need to do and how often she wants my feedback. I am checking in with my coach Umberto for nutrition and training every single week. So we are in constant communication, which, and it's actually more than just once a week. We are talking a lot. So for me to be motivated now, of course, it's new for me. I'm like 1 week in, I'm really excited to do this. I have like all this like hype and motivation and inspiration to do all these different things and new training program and new nutrition to follow, and all the new things are fun, right? But I know over the next few weeks, it's gonna burn off pretty quickly, and it's just gonna be a matter of like rinse and repeat. And for me, that's what I thrive on. I thrive on routine and pattern. So right now for me, it's gonna be easy. And I say that very lightly. It's not that it's easy. For me and my lifestyle and what I've been through in the past, I find this very manageable and sustainable for me to do. Now, I'm still gonna go out to restaurants. I'm still gonna go out with my friends and go on adventures and stuff. Yes, that means I need to plan ahead a little bit more. I need to do meal prep a lot more than what I was doing, because before I technically wasn't doing meal prep, but it does take a little bit of planning. And again, I thrive on that. I'm a scheduler, I like to be organized. So for me to spend an extra few minutes preparing some meals and taking them with me as I go on all my wild adventures, I'm totally okay with doing that. There is going to be a time later in prep, probably within like 4 to 6 weeks out, where my strength is really gonna drop. I know it's gonna suck. I went through that before. I told you guys about that, but I will be open and honest about all of that again. So comment below if there's anything specific that you wanna see, if you have any questions about. I know that on the IGTV episode that I did announce this, there were a lot of questions and feedback that you guys wanted or were sharing with me or wanted to see. So add to that or comment below if there's anything specific you want to see. But this is basically my introduction of my first vlog of the series of my bikini competition. I'm excited, and thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching. Thank you for being active and caring about all of these videos. We'll talk soon, strong friends.